I'm Greg Wilson, a paleontologist from the University of Washington, and I'm sitting here at a locality called the Denver Strike Locality. This is a locality that preserves a large individual of a Triceratops dinosaur. And what's around me are some white plaster jackets that we've begun the process of excavating, as well as some exposed bones. So right here you have a rib, and behind me are elements of the skull, including a very large frill and parts of orbital horns on that large skull. And then here are some vertebrae of this individual. And we're sitting in the Hell Creek Formation. This is from the late Cretaceous period. And we're about 3 to 5 meters below what we think is the Cretaceous-Paleogene boundary, so about 66 million years ago. So where we're sitting is about 100 to 200,000 years before that KT boundary. Before me here is a plaster jacket covering, this white stuff is a plaster jacket covering parts of the skull of a Triceratops individual. And what we have here is sort of an overturned part of the back shield of this Triceratops dinosaur. So it had a big, large back shield. This is only part of it. And then right where my hands are sides of the cheek and the eye socket here and the orbital horn. So a horn that went over its brow. So it would have a second horn like that and then one on its nose. And we've collected parts of that already. And this was what seems to be a very old individual. It's a very large skull. And as these animals go through life, they continue to grow. They have indeterminate growth. So it being a large skull, we think that it was an old individual. How old exactly, we don't know for sure. But we could look at cross sections of its bone and start to look at how that bone was deposited through the life of that individual. Triceratops is similar in form to a rhinoceros in terms of the horns on its skull, as well as the stockiness and the build of its body and the way that it moved, most likely. And it had a grinding battery of teeth that would have chomped on plants and eaten plants for all of its diet. And these guys are extremely common in the Hell Creek, and they would have been on all over the landscape here.